Hey, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. This is the new Whiteboard series from the Virtual Strategist. My name is Erica Olson. Today, we're talking about AI strategy, specifically about responsible AI. This is one part of a four-part series related to developing your responsible AI policy for your organization. There was an overview video, so check it out if you didn't check out that first. But today, we're talking about one part of your AI, your responsible AI policy, which is guiding principles, AI guiding principles. Let's jump in to the whiteboard. All right, so here is our handy dandy little whiteboard. As always, we're giving you a way to guide a conversation with you and your organization to create clarity, direction, and in this case, AI guiding principles. So just in context again, having a responsible AI policy in place for your organization is critical to thriving and yielding the benefits that AI can have for you and your team. Guiding principles are one piece of several pieces of that policy, if you will. I kind of like these the most, and I just want to say the importance of these is that they're articulated in a manner that everybody can look at them and say, yep, I know that I am acting and behaving in a manner that complies, that adheres to these guiding principles. Because after all, what we're doing individually as individual contributors in organizations today is, quite frankly, ungovernable. So people can do anything with AI in your organization. And these guiding principles are intended to say, hey, as a team showing up under your brand, under your direction, under your values, this is what's expected. And it's so important to be clear. So here we go. First things first, the first section is everything rises and falls with the current values you have in place. These guiding principles should be an extension, really, of your core values. So it's always nice to list those. You might have it memorized. And then the next thing that you want to do is to identify the different themes or areas that you would like to develop guiding principles around. So we've got a whole list here for you. One thing you can do is if you use our Miro board, by the way, if you want to use this Miro board, check out the link, click on it. It'll take you to the Miro board. You can use the voting piece in Miro to actually vote and ask your team which ones you want to have a guiding principle around. That's one way to do it. Another thought, by the way, is to pre-populate some topics that you want to make sure you have guiding principles around. And I might just make a couple recommendations. You probably should have a guiding principle around data and how data is used and where data can be used using open source AI or not, as the case may be. Very important. So that would be one guiding principle. That would be something that that you should have a guiding principle around. Another one you should probably have a guiding principle around is authentic content creation. So, and what I mean by that is if your team is using your content and maybe other content that is created from an LLM, how much of it needs to be original in order to be acceptable use. So there's a lot of different thoughts on that. And certainly if you are in the advertising space or the marketing space, you probably have attorneys that are helping guide that. So, but just the point on that is probably a guiding principle around what constitutes original content and what constitutes plagiarism. Another guiding principle topic that you might wanna make sure that you have clearly articulated is your stance on jobs and how you view AI in the context of job replacement or job superpowers, right? So what is it? And so that it's really, really clear. And that's a pretty important thing to be aligned around as an executive team so you don't have a different thought 6 months from now in related to AI use. The last thing that you probably want a guiding principle around would be around bias. Just as a suggestion, Often what is a concern right now is that we're forwarding inherent and implicit bias that is in large data sets. We're forwarding that by using AI, and that's certainly not what anybody wants to do. So how are you going to prevent against that? So again, you can easily just ChatGPT AI guiding principles, but that's not the point. The point is to really have a conversation with you and your team, part three, here to identify, theme, synthesize, and build what your guidelines are for your organization. Once you have those, you're going to want to build them out in detail below. So that's, again, just, you know, ideate on what they might be and then actually develop them. You don't need to wordsmith together, of course, but intention of what you want them to be should be done together. Now, you can see over here, I've actually just added our guiding principles, if you can see those, over off to the right-hand side. Those are actually the guiding principles that we wrote, the On Strategy team wrote for our team. And you can kind of see what we put together is we'll learn from one another, we'll protect our customer and proprietary data, no loading up people's strategic plans into OpenAI. We will not be replacing anyone's work with AI. We will value experimentation and understand that, you know, we are going to learn, fail, and learn again. And we are going to avoid reinforcing unfair bias. And we're going to make sure we don't use data sets that have bias, that we know have bias built into them. So anyways, you can kind of see how we built them. I thought it was good to see an example. And again, the tip on this is they're written in a manner that someone can read them and say, I am complying with these guidelines. They're written in the positive, not the negative, but, you know, depending upon how firm you want to be with that, pick your poison, so to speak. So with that, really simple, easy, doable approach to develop AI guiding principles as part of your responsible AI policy for your organization. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please make sure to subscribe to the channel because we're dropping videos on this topic and many others, and you'll get notified if you do. Happy strategizing. We'll see you next time.